Yes, hello, my dear students. Welcome back to St. Joseph Composite U College. I'm Rahul, Chemistry Faculty. Today, I just want to start the new topic, that is D block elements. The term block is very important for us because in the periodic table, there are four different blocks are there. That kind of classification is done on the basis of where the electron is entering. If the last electron is entering into the s orbital, then it is called s block elements. If the electron is entering in the p orbital, then it is called d block elements. If the last electron is entering in d orbital, then it is called a d block elements. Now let's understand that what are d block elements. The same kind of definitions will write here. Now first let me explain you that what is penultimate shell. So now if it is a nucleus and here is one shell, 2, 3, 4, now assume that this n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, and this one n is equal to 5. So where even we can give some names here. This is called K, L, M, and this one is N shell. Okay. Now the last shell, the N shell, is called here as valence shell. Valence shell it is. Everyone knows this. This is called as valence shell. The last shell is called as valence shell. Now the M shell is called as penultimate shell. Penultimate shell. Now the L shell, which is before the you can say that penultimate shell, it's called as a pre-penultimate shell. That let it be, that's not important for us. We need only this penultimate shell. So when we write the 3D, 4D or 5D orbitals, the D orbital is responsible for the chemical properties, not as the valence shell, that's the last shell. So therefore here the penultimate shell is considered as very important. In D block elements, last electron entering into the n-1 d orbital of this penultimate shell, that we have to mention. And that is known as d block element. Hope you understood. This is the definition for the d block element. If the last electron is entering into n-1 d orbital of penalty, then what is the n here? N is the valence shell number or the last. Okay. Now there are some classifications are there. The transition elements. So they can call it the transition elements or typical transition metals or non-typical transition metal, that we have to discuss first. The first I'm going to discuss, the first one, transition elements. Transition elements we have to discuss first. So these are the elements in which incompletely filled n-1 d orbitals are there. Okay, so in this n-1 d orbitals are incompletely filled. Incompletely filled, that n-1 d orbital, if there exists, even there in the elementary state or in a oxidized state, both in oxidized state and elementary state. What is the meaning of elementary state? Elementary state means single atom, if it is exist, is not forming any kind of bond with anything. So then it is called elementary state. They are called as a transition elements. Okay, that is one part. Now in that, typical transition metals are there. These are elements. So again, the elements, the transition elements are classified into two parts. The one part is called as a typical transition metals. Metal. Even in some textbook, they mention that transition metals are those which exist between the S and P block elements because they have the properties exist between the S and P block elements. Means S block are highly electropositive and P block are highly electronegative elements, but D block elements have in between properties. So therefore, it is also called as a transition element, that is given in some textbook, but it is not that. Now, what are the typical transition metals? The elements which have incompletely filled, the same definition we have to provide here. The n-1 d orbital मेरा क्या डी ऑर्बिटल ऑर्बिटल्स शुड बी इनकम्प्लीटली फिल्ड ओके नाउ इट बिकम अ ट्रांजिशन एलिमेंट राइट वी हैव सेम डेफिनेशन हियर गिवन इन बोथ ऑक्सिडाइज्ड एंड एलिमेंटल स्टेट अलोंग विद दिस दे शुड शो सम ऑफ द properties like they show variable oxidation state shows variable oxidation states variable shows that shows variable oxidation like if you take a carbon have a fixed valency it shows always a plus 4 or minus 4 oxidation state there is a 4 is a constant for that if you take Mn is one of the element belongs to the transition elements. This shows a plus 2 oxidation state and also it shows a plus 7 oxidation state and also it shows a plus 4 oxidation state. Mn plus 4 also shows. So various oxidizing states are possible. Even copper can show plus 1 and plus 2. Okay, titanium shows the different oxidation. It is not associated with the fixed valency. The oxidation state changes. Right, that is one part. Second one is that these metals as they containing empty or half filled or incompletely filled d orbital they have capacity to accumulate or take the electron pairs from the negative ions and they going to form a complex compounds formation of complex compounds hope you know that's complex compounds so hemoglobin is also in a complex compound okay so many applications are there for the complex compounds and you have separate topics the coordination compound they study the formation of complex compounds and their properties okay when the complex are formed or any of the compound is formed by the typical transition elements they always show colored compounds are formed that is one part now move to the next one that is third one non-typical transition element non-typical very simple is that non-typical transition elements or metals transition metals now as I mentioned here in the beginning the in the typical transition elements this part that is let me take underline this the n minus 1 d orbitals are there now they are incompletely filled in their elemental or in the oxidized state but when you go for the non-typical transition elements the d block that is n minus 1 d orbitals are completely filled and they are zinc the d10 configuration cadmium d10 configuration or mercury also d10 configuration okay so in this you can say that n minus 1 d orbitals are completely filled okay they have a d10 configuration let me write this one like here n minus 1 d10 is there 10 electrons are there in a orbital the capacity is completely filled okay so we can take some examples like zinc cadmium and mercury okay you can take here they are excluded these are excluded from the transition element these elements are excluded from transition excluded means removed excluded they are not included they are excluded from transition element hope you understood this right they are not included they are not called as the transition elements they are called as a non typical transition metal but why we are still considering in the d block elements okay we are considering as a d series we consider these elements belongs to D series. Reason is very simple. Reason is when you go for the chemical properties, their chemical properties are exactly same as the D block elements or transition elements because of their chemical behavior. Their chemical properties are same as that of transition element. Therefore, they are belongs to the D block element. So this is all about the you can say that introduction of our D block elements. In the next video, I'm going to make the position in the periodic table of those d block elements and we'll discuss the electronic configuration and also we're going to discuss the some electronic configuration exceptions are there for chromium and copper and not only chromium and copper so some other elements are there in the 4D and 5D series, we'll discuss that. And after that, we're going to discuss the general characteristic of transition metal. Till that, thank you for watching.